students, next we will discuss about the methodologies of the sequencing the human genome. Okay, means what are the methods to determine the sequences of the human genome. Sequencing means to determine the sequence that are present in the human genome. Okay, and the genome, it has the chromosomes, and the chromosomes, it has the genes. So the sequences that are present in the chromosomes. So how we will come to know about the sequencing method? There are two approaches for that. First is that to know only the sequences which will expressed as the RNA. Okay, EST means the expressed sequence tags. EST means expressed sequence tags, means those to determine the sequences which are responsible or which are expressed as the RNA. It means the to determine the sequences which act as the coding sequences. So now next is sequence annotation. Sequence annotation means to determine the sequences of all the genes, means coding as well as the non-coding. As in case of EST, only the coding regions. But in case of the sequence annotation, to determine the sequence of all the genes. Okay, means all the segments, the coding as well as the non-coding regions of the human genome. So these are the two approaches, and one method is there, that is automated DNA sequence, and it is developed by the Frederick Sanger, and that's why it is also known as the Sanger method. As this method, it is developed by the Frederick Sanger, so that's why it is also known as the Sanger method. So now in this method, what is done? First of all, the DNA that is isolated. First of all, the DNA that is isolated, and then this DNA, it is amplified. It is amplified by using the vectors or even the PCR. But first of all, as the DNA that is isolated, then it should be separated or it should be produced into the DNA fragments by the restriction enzymes. As I told you, that what are the restriction enzymes? These restriction enzymes, they act as the scissors, and they cut the DNA at the specific sites. So after the DNA isolation, by the help of the restriction enzyme, DNA, it is separated or it is cut into the DNA fragments. Okay, at the specific points. So now by the action of the restriction enzymes, what happened? The DNA fragments that are produced, these are the DNA fragments. So when the DNA fragments that are produced, then these DNA fragments that are amplified. Amplified means that these DNA fragments that are produced in the large number. Okay, by the process of the PCR as well as by the process of the vectors. Now, what is PCR? PCR, it is a machine that is polymerase chain reaction, which help in the amplification, means which help in producing the more copy number of the DNA. Okay, and vectors, what are vectors? These are the plasmids. These are the plasmids of the, which are obtained from the host organism, and these are extracted from the host organism. And all of you know what is plasmid, that is the extra chromosomal DNA. And if suppose this plasmid, it is extracted from the bacteria. Okay, from the bacteria it is extracted, and then in the one portion, these DNA fragments that are inserted. Okay, so this is known as the vector. In the vector, the DNA fragment that is inserted, and now this is again introduced into the same bacteria. Now this is known as the host organism. Okay, in the organism in which this vector that is again inserted by introducing the foreign gene, means by introducing the DNA fragment. Then what will happen when it is introduced into this cell? Then it will produce its more number by using the cell machinery, it will produce its number, and as well as the DNA fragment which is present here, it will also become large, means it will also produce the more copy number. So there are two method. One that is the PCR machine, in which what happens, the DNA fragments that are loaded and the time that is set, and then after some time what will happen, so many number of the same fragment that is produced. But in case of the vectors, what happen, from a organism the vector, that is the plasmid or the extra chromosomal DNA, that is extracted, and then this DNA fragment that is inserted, and then again it is introduced into the same host organism for producing the more number by the replication. Okay, and then when the DNA fragments that are produced in large quantity, then again it is extracted from the cell. So if suppose the host organism, in case of the vectors, it is bacteria. If the bacteria it is used, then it is known as, if the host organism is bacteria, then bacterial artificial chromosome, it is known as, this vector is known as bacterial artificial chromosome. And if suppose in case of the yeast, it is the organism in which the vector it is introduced or inserted for producing the more number of copies of the DNA fragments, then it is known as yeast artificial chromosome. Then it is known as yeast artificial chromosome. Okay, and this is known as back, and this is known as neck. Okay, bacterial artificial chromosome, if the host organism that is bacteria, and in case of yeast, it is known as yeast artificial chromosome. These are the name of the vectors in which these DNA fragments that are inserted for producing the more copy number of the DNA fragment. So now the more number of the means more copy number that are produced of the DNA. Now next method is, means this automated DNA sequence which is developed by the Frederick Sanger. So by this method what happened, the computer program, what it will do, it will determine the sequences from both the ends. Suppose this is the sequence. So this sequence, it is determined from the two ends, from this end also and from this end also. And if suppose any overlapping sequences that are present, okay, means that two sequences that are overlapped each other, so it is very difficult to read that sequence. So this method, it will separate those overlapping sequences, it will separate the sequences and then rejoin the sequence. So remove the overlapping, and after removing, then join those sequences into one stretch. If suppose the overlapping sequences that are present, then these overlapping sequences that are separated, removed, and then join the sequences into a common stretch, and then read the sequence. So after reading the sequence, what happened, that the chromosome sequence we will come to know, means the sequencing of the chromosome will be there. So when the chromosome sequencing will be over, in this manner all the chromosomes that are sequenced one by one, okay, like first, second, third, fourth, fifth, and in this manner all the chromosomes that are sequenced. So when all the chromosomes that are sequenced, then we will come to know the sequencing of the human genome, because the human genome, it consists of the chromosomes only. So how many chromosomes that are present? Around 22 pairs that are autosomes, and one that is X and Y, that are the sex chromosomes. So now this time, all the 22 autosome chromosomes that are sequenced, as well as the sex chromosome that is X and Y, that are also sequenced. So we will come to know about the sequencing of the human genome in this way.